गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. स्टडे ऑलरेडी वी हैव स्टार्टेड द यूनिट 3 इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी द सेम इलेक्ट्रोकेमिस्ट्री एंड द टॉपिक इज इलेक्ट्रोड पोटेंशियल. स्टडे वी हैव रेड अबाउट इलेक्ट्रोकेमिकल शेल. नाउ द क्वेश्चन इज रेस्ड, what is electrode potential, what is cell potential, what is standard electrode potential, like that. Now electrode potential, students please write, the potential difference developed between electrode and aqueous solution of its metal ion is known as electrode potential. Clear? Now, this electrode potential is of two types. One is oxidation electrode potential. You can write EOX, and second is reduction electrode potential. It is E-red. Now see, potential difference developed between electrode and its metal. Now please try to note down the definition of oxidation electrode potential. If oxidation takes place between electrode and its metal ion, then the developed potential is known as oxidation electrode potential, that is EOX. Similarly, the same way, if the electrode is dipped in its aqueous solution of its metal ion, is known as reduction electrode potential. Now, after that, there is next topic, standard electrode potential. Standard electrode potential. It is represented by E naught. It is also electrode potential, but here in a standard electrode potential there is some condition. The condition is what? The condition is the concentration of electrolyte should be 1 molar, temperature should be 298 Kelvin, and for gaseous electrode the pressure should be 1 bar. Under that condition, the potential difference developed between electrode and its metal ion is known as standard electrode potential. So, you can write the definition of standard electrode potential as follows. Try to write it. The electrode potential developed between the electrode and its metal ion when the concentration of the metal ion solution is 1 molar, temperature is 298 Kelvin, and pressure is 1 bar is known as standard electrode potential. Now, in same manner, it is also classified in two parts. One is E naught ox and other is E naught red. It means standard oxidation potential and standard reduction potential. But by convention, we always measure the standard reduction potential, whatever the situation is. There may be oxidation, there may be reduction. reduction, if there is reduction, then no problem. If there is oxidation, we always use the reduction potential to maintain the sign convention. And one point, just I am giving one example. What is the relation between E naught ox and E naught red of a particular electrode? For example, E naught Zn solid slash Zn2 plus aqueous is equal to plus 0.76 volt. And E naught Zn2 plus aqueous slash Zn solid is equal to minus 0.76 volt. You see, oxidation potential, standard oxidation potential and standard reduction electrode potential, both are having same magnitude. Only sign has been changed. And E naught, the standard oxidation electrode potential of zinc is equal to plus 0.76 volt, while the standard reduction electrode potential of zinc is minus 0.76 volt. Now this is the situation, and to maintain the sign convention proper during solving any numerical, suppose in question teacher has given standard oxidation potential, your first job is that you have to convert the standard oxidation electrode potential into standard reduction electrode potential, and then you have to solve the numerical. Now one thing more, E cell is equal to what? E cell, EMF of the cell. E cell means EMF of the cell. E cell is equal to E cathode minus E anode. Similarly, for standard condition, E naught cell is equal to E naught cathode minus E naught anode. Now this is the situation. In next topic, we will study that how the electrode potential of any electrode can be measured. For study of that, before explanation of that part, we are going to study the construction and function of standard hydrogen electrode, SHE, or normal hydrogen electrode. We are going to explain the construction and function of standard hydrogen electrode, SHE, or normal hydrogen electrode, NHE. Actually, there is little bit confusion among students. Sir, is SHE or NHE, are SHE or NHE same? In normal sense, both are same, but in actual sense, SHE, standard hydrogen electrode, will be written if the hydrogen gas part, you look the figure, I will explain the figure. The hydrogen gas is passed at 1 bar and temperature is 298 Kelvin. And if it is NHE, normal hydrogen electrode, then the hydrogen gas passed is at 1 atm, 1 atmospheric pressure, and temperature is 298 Kelvin. Now everything is same. In this construction, what is there? There is platinum electrode which is dipped in 1 molar aqueous solution of H plus ion. Student can make the note and they should write my lecture. what SH is, suppose one is asking what is SHE, your answer will be the standard hydrogen electrode is the electrode in which platinum electrode is dipped in 1 molar aqueous solution of HCl or HNO3, through which hydrogen gas at 1 bar pressure and 298 Kelvin temperature is bubbled through it. Hydrogen gas is passed, naturally it will bubble out. Now the question is, now see the figure. This is a glass jacket. This is connecting wire. You know already platinum is very costly, you should know. So this is connected to normal copper wire. This is platinum electrode. And the copper wire is covered by the jacket. Hydrogen gas is passed through it. This is platinum. It is written finely divided, platinum coated on platinum foil. This solution is 1MH+. 1MH+. That may be HCl, that may be HNO3. And the hydrogen gas is bubbled. This SHE, now I am going to write its function. What is function of this? SHE is used as reference electrode. And with the help of SHE, we can measure the standard electrode potential of any electrode. This SHE may act as anode as well as it may act as cathode. So SHE as anode. Yes, sir. Half H2 gives H plus aqueous plus one electron. Oxidation takes place. Is this representation? Half shell representation is the representation. This is H2 gas 1 bar / PT solid / H plus 1M. It is represented like this. If SHE act as anode, and if SHE act as cathode, already you know that I have told at anode there is oxidation, at cathode there is reduction. So here it will be H plus aqueous plus one electron gives half H2 gas. Now again, half shell representation, H plus 1M / H2 gas 1 bar / PT solid. Now see, in some books, at the place before 1 bar and after 1 bar and PT, there may be comma. There may be / there may be comma. You can write like this also. This also, no problem. So, SHE act as reference electrode. On SHE, oxidation may take place. On SHE, reduction may take place. Now, by convention, I already, by convention you can tell E0 F plus / H2 is equal to 0.004. The standard electrode potential of hydrogen is 0.00 volt. Now, with the help of SHE, we can measure the standard reduction electrode potential of any electrode. Now, I am going to explain The next topic, measurement of electrode potential. Measurement of standard reduction electrode potential. It is not red. How you measure? Now suppose we are going to already in question your in text question in text 3.1. This is a question in text 3.1. That is a question. How would you determine the standard electrode potential of the system Mg2+/Mg? This question may be asked theoretically, but for your knowledge, I am going to explain. Suppose I have taken the electrode like zinc or magnesium even. We are going to measure the electrode potential of magnesium. Now, what to do? You have to take SHE, and here it is Mg2+ aqueous. This is magnesium electrode. This is connected by voltmeter, and this is connected with this. This is magnesium, and this is salt bridge. Should maintain with salt bridge. Salt bridge. The logic is, the electrode whose standard reduction electrode potential is to be measured should be connected with standard hydrogen electrode. We are not knowing whether on electrode oxidation take place in reference of SHE or on electrode reduction take place in reference of SHE. Condition may be any. Here, on the basis of the deflection of this voltmeter, we judge that here oxidation take place and it acts as anode and SHE act as cathode. Here in this case, magnesium act as anode and SHE act as cathode. Now, suppose the deflection reading, the reading in voltmeter is somewhat, this is 2.36 volt. Suppose this reading is 2.36 volt. Suppose X volt, no problem. Suppose you can check any example, no. Now E cell, E naught cell is equal to what? E naught cathode minus E naught anode. Now this value is what? 2.36 is equal to what? E naught cathode is SHE. E naught cathode means E naught H+/H2 minus E naught Mg2+/Mg. This will be such a situation. Or 2.36 is equal to, this is 0.00 minus E naught Mg2+/Mg solid. Therefore, E naught Mg2+/Mg solid is equal to minus 2.36 volt. What do we observe here? Here we observe that the electrode on which oxidation takes place in reference of SHE, that electrode act as anode and SHE act as cathode. So that electrode has their inert red value always negative. Suppose you are taking zinc. The zinc, on zinc, oxidation takes place in reference of SHE. Therefore, E naught Zn2 plus slash Zn is equal to minus 0.76 volt. That value is negative also. Similarly, if you take copper, suppose measurement of E naught Cu2 plus Cu. What do you observe? Cu act as cathode. The same pattern. Just like in previous example, suppose you are asked to measure standard electrode potential of copper. Then copper rod is dipped in Cu2 plus aqueous, one mole Cu2 plus aqueous, and it is connected with SHE. We observe that under that in complete cell, there must be the formation of the cell. In that cell, here it will be SHE, and this will be passed like this, so figure will be clear. H2, this is salt bridge, you take copper. See copper connected. So Cu solid, Cu2 plus aqueous, 1m equator, 1m H plus, 1 bar. Just you can frame your figure as you like. Now here, copper acts as cathode and SHE act as anode. Check. E naught cell is equal to 0.34 volt. Therefore, E naught cell is equal to what? E naught cathode minus E naught anode. So 0.34 volt, E naught cathode is what? E naught Cu2 plus slash Cu solid, this is 0.00 volt. So therefore, E naught Cu2 plus slash Cu solid is equal to plus 0.34 volt. So what we observe? The standard reduction electrode potential of copper is plus 0.34 volt. So the negative value of E naught rate or positive value of E naught rate is only based upon whether the electrode act as anode in reference of SHE or whether the electrode act as cathode in reference of SHE. Now, after measurement of this standard reduction electrode potential, our next topic will be electrochemical series. You may write the definition of this electrochemical series. Please write. The systematic arrangement of elements in decreasing order of their standard reduction electrode potential from positive value to negative value is known as electrochemical series. Now, in your NCERT book, look, this is your NCERT book. In NCERT book, the table 3.1. Look, this in the top of this electrochemical series, there is F2, fluorine. Its value is 2.87 volt. And in the bottom, this is lithium, minus 3.05 volt. In the middle, there is hydrogen. 2H plus plus 2 electron gives H2 gas. Its value is 0.00 volt. So don't take tension that you have to learn all this value. No, no need to learn all this value, because in numerical, in question, we will supply, teacher will give the value of their standard reduction electrode potential E0 rate. So, you know, this is electrochemical series. In class 10, you have read reactivity series. This electrochemical series seems to be similar to reactivity series, but there is slight difference here. Now, in the next topic, it is application. This is important, very important topic. Application of electrochemical series. Application of electrochemical series. This is very important topic. Generally, question is asked based on this. And question is not like that, write the all application of electrochemical series. The question is not like that. Now, the first application is this. Please write. The electrode which have their the element which have their E0 red value negative, if they react with mineral acid, they release hydrogen gas. Just take for example, Zn react with H2SO4, give ZnSO4 plus H2. But Cu does not release H2 when react with H2SO4. Why? Why? Because E0 Zn2 plus Zn solid is equal to minus 0.76 volt and E0 Cu2 plus Cu solid is equal to plus 0.34 volt. So what you got here? Those elements which are having negative value of E0 rate, they react with mineral acid to release hydrogen gas, while those elements which are having positive E0 rate, they will not release H2 gas when they react with mineral acid. Now, the second application. Any formation of any cell is possible if the value of E cell is positive. It's very clear. And the value of E cell, not E0 cell, must be positive. Example, in Zn Cu cell, Zn act as anode and Cu act as cathode. Very trick is here. In a study class, I have told electron flows from anode to cathode and current flows from cathode to anode. In physics you have read, there is flow of current always from higher potential to lower potential. But natural, the E cathode must be higher than E anode. The same concept is here. Because E naught cell is equal to what? E naught cell is equal to E naught cathode minus E naught anode. So naturally, plus 0.34 minus 76 is equal to plus 1.10 volt. So E naught cell is positive here. So E naught cell possible is, it means in any cell, the value, the electrode which has E naught red value positive act as cathode, and the electrode which has E naught red value negative act as anode. Now application number 3. This application number 3 is very important, because application number 3, you can write, those chemical reaction, those chemical reactions are feasible which have their E naught red value, E naught red value positive. It's a very important application. Those chemical reactions are feasible. Feasible means possible, means spontaneous. So those chemical reactions are feasible which have their E naught red value positive. If E naught red value, sorry, not E naught red, having their E naught cell, please correct it, having their E naught cell value positive. There is a question. Is it possible to store aqueous solution of CuSO4 in zinc container? Suppose one is asking. Given E naught Zn2 plus Zn is equal to minus 0.76 volt, and E naught Cu2 plus Cu is equal to plus 0.34 volt. On the basis of class 10 level, you can give your answer. You know the answer. But in class 10, the answer is given on the basis of reactivity series. But here, the answer is given on the basis of calculation of E naught cell value. Now, answer. Let the reaction is feasible. Suppose we have reaction is feasible. Then Zn solid plus CuSO4 aqueous gives ZnSO4 aqueous plus Cu solid. What happens? Here oxidation is at 0, here it is plus 2, here it is plus 2, here it is 0. So here reduction takes place. Reduction. And here oxidation takes place. Here Zn act as anode and Cu act as cathode. Therefore E naught cell is equal to E naught Cu2 plus Cu minus E naught Zn2 plus Zn. value is equal to plus 0.34. You see, here the anode cell is positive. It means anode cell is equal to positive. So above reaction take place and we cannot store CuSO4 solution in zinc container. Naturally, if the reaction will take place, you cannot store the CuSO4 solution in zinc container. Now I am going to ask the opposite of this. Then suppose one is asking, is it possible to store aqueous solution of ZnSO4? Aqueous solution of ZnSO4 in copper container. Suppose the question is like this. Given value is this. Suppose the reaction is 4. Again, you assume the same thing. Suppose, let the reaction is feasible. Then what you write? ZnSO4. ZnSO4 plus Cu solid gives CuSO4 aqueous plus Zn solid. Here, plus 2, 0, 0, plus 2. It means reduction, copper, oxidation. What is the situation? No problem. But here it is assumption only. So here, Zn act as cathode. Copper act as anode. Therefore, anode cell is equal to anode cathode minus anode anode. Cathode is what? Zinc 76 minus 0.34 minus 1.10 volt. What we observe? We observe here, anode cell is equal to negative. It means the given reaction is not feasible. It means we can store aqueous solution of ZnSO4 in copper container. Some more applications are also given in the books. We should go through that and we should make the notes. This is enough for today. In next class, we will study about the effect of concentration and temperature on electrode potential. It means Nernst equation. Equilibrium constant gives free energy like that. Thank you.